Hey guys, Gloria McDonald here. Today I'm going to share with you my number one secret for overcoming objections and closing the sale. It's all about overcoming the objections. That's my secret for today. So I'm going to turn my camera around. This is the low-tech part of this. But first, for those of you who don't know me, I coach network marketers, affiliate marketers, home-based business owners on how to create the life and dream and the business you truly want to create. And I do that using the two most powerful tools there are in the world today, the power of your consciousness, your mind, your energy, and the power of the internet. So let's talk about the secret to overcoming objections. So I'm gonna flip my camera around here because I've got my flip chart out again today. Let's get this flipped around. This is the low tech part of this, me flipping around my camera. So I talked a little bit on Monday about the close. And we're going to dig into that a little bit deeper. So on Monday, I mentioned that there are four reasons why people say no to your business opportunity. So let's talk about reason number one. It's the no, like, and trust factor. So people will say no to your business opportunity if they don't know, like, and trust you yet. So this is where my Mastering Conversations That Close, the Ultimate Network Marketer's Guide to Creating Connection and Turning Prospects into Partners. In that free guide that I will give you the link to, I give you the template, the exact script I use for what I call the Island of Your Dreams conversation. When you go through this Island of Your Dreams conversation, you automatically take care of this problem of the no, like, and trust factor. So what happens in this conversation is you listen more than you talk. So when you talk at someone, it feels to them like a sales pitch. But when they talk, they learn about themselves. And the whole idea of this Island of Your Dreams conversation and really mastering the art of closing is to get people to talk about their dreams and get them to start to understand themselves. And when they do that, they feel heard, they feel special, and they feel a connection with you, which is so important. And again, in this Mastering Conversations That Close ebook, my free guide that I'm going to give you the link to, I walk you step by step through this conversation. So reason number two why people say no to your business opportunity is they're wondering in their head, will your business opportunity really help them? So their question in their head at a subconscious level is, will this work for me? So here are two keys to overcoming this. You give them an example, but there's a huge warning around this because I've heard this done very badly. You might give them an example of someone like them who's been successful, but here's my huge warning around this one. I really don't like this one unless you have had a very, very thorough conversation with the person and you've gotten to know their dreams and their desires quite well. So I heard another guru in the network marketing space talk about this, and the example they gave, I just wanted to cringe. She used an example of someone, let's say, who's my age, in their early 60s. And how this business, if you really grow this business, blah, 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 this will give you the opportunity to retire and stay home with your grandkids. Well, if someone was talking to me and they knew me, they would know that I have no desire to retire and stay at home with grandkids. I don't have grandkids, but even if I did, I have no desire to retire. I love what I'm doing. I'm excited about what I'm doing. Or another example, because this was another example that was given, was you're talking to a young a mother with young kids, and you talk about how, well, you know, this business opportunity, there's so-and-so who's been so successful in this business, and she grew from here to here in 12 months, and now she's able to stay at home with her kids. Well, there are lots of mothers with young kids who have no desire to be stay-at-home moms. And I would have been one of those, okay? So be really super careful when you're giving an example of someone that you think is like your prospect, that you know enough about your prospect not to make assumptions, that she wants to stay home with young kids, or she wants to retire really soon, or whatever. So the next thing you can do here is give a brief, and I mean super brief, outline of your plan of how to get them to success. Now, this is not your company's compensation plan. This is not, I repeat, your company's compensation plan. This is more like saying, Gloria, you know, I will be there with you every step of the way. I'll be like your GPS. I'll tell you to turn right, stay straight, turn left, stay straight, turn left. I'll help you every step of the way. We've got fantastic tools, and I know how to do this, and I will be there to help you. And then ask them, so are you willing to put in the effort? Because we all know that building any business, and especially building a network marketing business, requires effort. So, reason number three why people will say no to your opportunity is they're not committed to their dream and getting what they want. And this is huge. So people are interested in a lot of things, but they'll only invest in things they're committed to getting. So it's difficult to commit to what they really want because of fears, self-doubts, and avoiding change. As human beings, A, we all have fears, we all have self-doubts, and we do not like change. So what you need to do is step out of your comfort zone and get your prospect to step out of their comfort zone. So reason number four, they say no to your business opportunity, that they don't join you, is they don't believe in themselves enough. So they have fears. They have fears that they can't do this business, that they can't change, that they might fail, that they might look like might look foolish, they might look bad. And usually your prospect is unaware of these fears. They're subconscious fears. So I've honestly never had a prospect say to me, ooh, I'm afraid I can't do this. Or, ooh, I'm afraid I'm gonna look like a fool to my friends and family members. They don't say those things. So instead what they'll do is they'll give you excuses that they don't have any time, that they don't have any money, that they have to check with their partner, their spouse, their boyfriend, their girlfriend, whatever. And that they have to think about it. Or that their intuition says no. That's my favorite, that their intuition says no. So your job in this whole Island of Your Dreams conversation, when you really learn how to master the close, your job is to take a stand for your prospect, to take a stand for their dream. But you don't know what that dream is unless you've done the Island of Your Dreams conversation. So again, these five objections: no time, no money, have to talk to my partner, my husband, my spouse, whatever, I have to think about it, or my intuition says no. These five objections, the key, the secret to overcoming these five objections is to overcome them before they even come up. And again, that's what this Island of Your Dreams conversation that I walk you through step by step by step in the Mastering Conversations That Close, the Ultimate Network Marketer's Guide to Creating Connection and Turning Prospects into Partners. That's what this guide will give you. So I will put the link above and below this video, and I highly recommend you click on it. It's my free gift to you. So remember this, I said this on Monday, but it's worth saying again. You do not want your prospects to say yes to your business opportunity. That is not what you want. What you want is you want your prospect to say yes to their dream. Because prospects who say yes to your business opportunity will fizzle out. But when they're truly connected to their dream and where they are right now and where they want to get to, when they have a very clear vision of where they want to get to, those are the people that will stick with your business, that will do what it takes, that will stick through the difficult times. They'll stick with it even though there's rejection. So you want the people who say yes to their dream, not the people who say yes to your business opportunity. So again, click on the link above or below this video for my free Mastering Conversations That Close guide. It's the ultimate network marketer's guide to creating connection and turning prospects into partners. Thanks so much. I'll see you again soon. Bye.